like the woman at the very beginning asked about climate and climate change and the effect of war on climate change. We've had long discussions about that at the meeting this morning, where we passed a resolution about campaigning over climate change and connecting with war. So I think people, you know, become hopefully or are becoming more aware of this as a very, very important issue. And I think you're right. It is, you know, you look at the US military alone, I mean, its carbon footprint is bigger than lots of countries. It's absolutely huge. So that's certainly a very big issue for us. The question about cooperation with the JCPOA, yes, well, I mean, whatever the issues with the JCPOA, it was an attempt to bring together different countries who had quite different views on foreign policy in order to try to get an agreement. And Trump has really just smashed that up. But what he's trying to do is to get outside Britain in terms of supporting that. And I think Jenny's point that, you know, when you look at where a lot of your papers go, you're talking about the potential for very big conflict. I mean, to be honest, wherever they go, you're talking about potential for conflict. Particularly when you look at the number that are going to China, that's absolutely true. Somebody raised the question of the nuclear weapons threat, and the, you know, I mean, I don't think it's a mythical threat. I think, you know, countries do want to develop nuclear weapons, and personally, I'm totally opposed to nuclear weapons. I think it's something that we shouldn't have nuclear weapons in the world. I think that they are absolutely destructive. When we talk about weapons of mass destruction, they're absolutely terrible. But as you rightly say, the United States is the only country that's actually used nuclear weapons, as it did in 1945 in Japan. And what is happening is that the major nuclear weapons powers are trying to stop everybody else getting nuclear weapons without, for a moment, wanting to disarm, although that is an agreement that they actually have, that they'll move towards disarm. So this is, you know, this is a major issue. Of course, we know that Israel in the Middle East is the only country in the Middle East which does have nuclear weapons, and nobody doubts this, even though it's not officially proclaimed. So I think we have to point out the hypocrisy, as well as saying we're not in favour of nuclear weapons for any state. That would be my argument, and I think that's an argument you could win with the Iranians, as long as they didn't think everybody was about to attack them. I mean, this is where people get this, the kind of the thought that they're going to do it. So, yeah, I mean, I think those are the main points. The only final point is, yes, please do please do hold meetings on this topic. Please do get involved, and please do get to Manchester for these protests.